It's What's the Buzz with Leo. That's right, it's me, Leo, interviewing the experts and taking you behind the scenes to find out all the buzz about the amazing work that's happening at Parks Canada to help our pollinators. Woo-wee, pollen heads! Have I got a story for you. It involves squirrels who don't just fly, but are important pollinators who disappeared from the Point Pelee Forest, but are once again back in their natural home. It may sound like a fairy tale, but it's all true! Tara from Point Pelee National Park is going to give us all the details on the amazing tale of the southern flying squirrel. Tara, flying squirrels, who would have thought? How do these adorable pollinators fly?
Good question, Leo.
So if you look close, you can actually see that there's patagium, and that's a piece of skin that goes from their ankle all the way to their wrist, and it allows them to glide from tree to tree.
Oh, so they are actually gliding squirrels.
Exactly.
So, how are these flying, gliding squirrels actually pollinators?
That's interesting you should ask that. They help to move fungus around, and that helps break down dead trees in the forest, and that helps the forest thrive and have those nutrients return to the soil and therefore have trees grow that are new.
Pollen heads! Flying squirrels don't just move the fungus, they actually eat the spores, which act like seeds.
Southern flying squirrels also will plant seeds in different parts of the forest, so seeds get forgotten and then you'll have seedlings that come up later on, and once again, it's kind of a cycle that they help to keep in check in the forest.
Wing-credible! So, they're really important to having a healthy forest?
Yeah, southern flying squirrels are really important to the ecosystem.
But then these important pollinators disappeared. How did that happen?
So flying squirrels in the park disappeared, unfortunately, for three different reasons. One of them was feral cats. There used to be a lot of cottages in the park, and unfortunately there were feral cats that came along with that. One of the other reasons was the park became almost an island because there's a lot of agriculture outside the park. Therefore, there weren't any squirrels able to come or go from the park. And then the other reason was
tree removal in the park.
So because of that, a lot of the mature forests were cut down, and also any snags that they might use to nest in were cut down.
Snag? What the heck is a snag?
A snag is a standing dead tree.
Huh. So, dead trees are important.
Yes, they're very important for the ecosystem. There's woodpeckers that use the trees, gray squirrels. There's lots of different animals that use dead trees. And they're also important for fungus and different ecosystem processes.
Wow.
So we know that flying squirrels are important to the health of the forest. And we know that they help to keep different parts of the forest connected to one another. So that's why we decided to reintroduce them to the park when they went missing.
And when did Operation Flying Squirrel start?
So the southern flying squirrels were reintroduced in 1993 and 1994. We had 99 that were reintroduced at that time.
But where did you get 99 flying squirrels?
So we actually got these flying squirrels from a neighboring county, and they had an abundance of flying squirrels. So they were willing to let us take a few to reintroduce them to the park. And it involved putting out boxes, nest boxes that would kind of attract them to them. And then eventually they would start kind of all congregating in those nest boxes as they like to do. And then that box would be plugged, and then they would get transferred in that way to the park, and then it would be unplugged, and that way they could kind of easily come out as they would get more comfortable.
How did the squirrels respond to their new forest home?
They actually found that they didn't really need to rely on the nest box, and they didn't need to rely on the food that was being supplied either. They found that they were finding an abundance of food, and that they also found lots of snags to home up in.
Aww, sounds like you had a lot of happy squirrels.
Yes, we had a lot of happy squirrels, which made us very happy. So the squirrels are back and they're doing their job. They're moving spores and they're moving seeds.
But that was then and this is now. How do you know that the squirrels are still happy here in Point Pelee?
Nowadays, we do have trap lines that are set up. We check the health of the squirrels, and we also check to see whether we're getting any pregnant females. So that tells us the population is doing well.
Well, that's pollen-tabulous. It must be exciting to have the flying squirrels back in the forest.
Yes, it's really gratifying to be able to see species come back into its natural habitat and help to reconnect all the systems. And who wouldn't want to see a very cute flying squirrel back in its habitat?
Exactly! Bringing pollinators back into an ecosystem where they went missing from is worth celebrating. A story with a true happy ending. and a super cute pollinator. So pollen heads, be mindful on your next walk in the woods. Those dead trees are actually full of life of another kind and homes to more than just our pollinating flying squirrels. So leave the snags where they are. Nature may look messy, but it's perfect. Later, pollinators.